The moment a baby is born, it's attacked by several microbes present around it. But not all organisms are successful in their attack. However, the body does not always win the battle either. There are many infections which successfully infect us, irrespective of our age groups. And not only this, but many a times it happens that this same infection repeats its occurrence. Take the common cold, for example. It's one of the most common infectious diseases caused by a virus known as rhinovirus. And what do we mean by infectious disease? The term infectious stands for liability of transmission. And the term disease literally means the body is not at ease. So a disease can be defined as an illness caused by numerous factors which withholds the body from functioning normally. There is one more concept similar to this which we need to know, and it's called disorder. And what does that mean? The term literally means the body is not able to work properly or simply is out of order. So are the two conditions different? Well, technically yes. Diseases are mainly caused by pathogens, that is, the external agents like viruses, fungi, bacteria, and so on, which enter the body and create problems. On the other hand, disorders are caused by some of the other defects in the functioning of certain cells or tissues. Take diabetes, for example. It can occur due to either improper production or improper uptake of insulin by the cells. Now, diseases are usually infectious or transmissible, whereas disorders are not. There are many sources which use the term non-infectious diseases synonymously with disorders. And what are these non-infectious diseases? Non-infectious diseases, as the name suggests, are those diseases which do not spread with mere contact. So logically, they can be used interchangeably. But for now, we will not get into the details of this classification of the types of diseases. Rather, we'll have a look at examples of each type. For studying infectious diseases in detail, we will have a look at some known diseases like malaria, typhoid, and a few others. On the other hand, for studying disorders, or say the non-infectious ones, we will have a look at an important example like cancer. Let's have a look at each one in detail in the upcoming videos.